In this lesson, we are going to look at the properties of a periodic table. So first of all, if you look at the periodic table, there are two important things. One of them is called the periods. Now, the periods are basically the horizontal rows on the periodic table going across. So we have first period, okay, period 1, period 2, 3, 4, and so on, okay? Now, a quick way to remember that period or horizontal going across like this, if we look at the H, right? Within the H, there's a line that going from left to right. It's a horizontal going left to right. So that's how you know that horizontal or periods, or horizontal rows going across the periodic table. Then we look at groups. Groups are the vertical columns going down. So we have group 1, group 2, and so on. Now, one quick way to memorize that verticals is going up and down is that we look at the letter V itself. So V is made up of two lines going up and down. We have one line here going down or going up, and we have another line going up and going down. So V for verticals going up and down, and group are basically vertical column going up and down. Now let's look at the individual element box on the periodic table. There are very important information about an element based on the information given on the periodic table. First of all, we have this number right here, the number on top. That is your atomic number. Each element on the periodic table has its unique atomic number. And this atomic number is also equal to the number of proton. Okay? Remember, this proton is a positive charge, subatomic particles located in a nucleus, right? Then we have the symbol for an element. An atomic number is unique to a specific element, so therefore is unique to an element symbol as well. Then we have the name of an element. So again, if we have a name of an element, we will know the symbols of an element. And we also know the atomic number of an element, and also we know about the number proton of an element. Lastly, we have the atomic mass of an element. Now, this is also known as the average atomic mass of an element. This is not the same thing as your mass number of an isotope, which we will cover later, because the mass number of an isotope is equal to the number of proton plus number of neutron only, specifically for the isotopes. One last thing that you need to know is that if an atom is neutral, that means the net charge is zero, okay? It has no charge at all. You need to know that the atomic number is equal to the number of proton and is also equal to the number of electron, because the positive of proton will cancel out with the negative of electron. So again, only happen in a neutral atom.